अस्सलामु अलैकुम रहमतुल्लाहि बरकातुहू। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी लर्न द चैप्टर क्वाड्रिलैटरल्स। सो व्हाट इज क्वाड्रिलैटरल? अ ज्योमेट्रिकल फिगर हैविंग फोर साइड्स इज कॉल्ड एज क्वाड्रिलैटरल। सो यू कैन सी द डायग्राम। एवरी क्वाड्रिलैटरल हैज फोर एंगल्स and four sides and two diagonals. So in this figure the sides of the quadrilateral are segment AB, segment BC, segment CD and segment AD. There are two diagonals in the quadrilateral, that is diagonal AC and diagonal BD. The angles in the quadrilateral are four angles: angle A, angle B, angle C and angle D. So angle A, angle B, angle C and angle D. There are four angles in the quadrilateral. Now observe the figure and write the following pairs considering the quadrilateral ABCD. So considering the quadrilateral ABCD, let us write the pairs of adjacent sides in this quadrilateral. Adjacent sides means the sides, two sides having one common vertex. So in this figure, segment side AB is adjacent to side BC, then side BC is adjacent to side CD, then side CD, third pair, side CD is adjacent to side AD, and side AD, side AD is adjacent to side AB. So there are four pairs of adjacent side. Then the pairs of adjacent angles. So adjacent angles, here in this figure, the adjacent angles, angle A is adjacent to angle B, first pair. Then angle B is adjacent to angle C, second pair. Third pair, angle C is adjacent to angle D, and fourth pair, angle D is adjacent to angle A. So there are in all four pairs of adjacent angles. Now which are the pairs of opposite sides in this quadrilateral? So there is no common vertex in the side, so opposite sides in front of one each other. So side AB, there are two pairs of opposite sides, side AB. AB is opposite to side CD, then side AD is opposite to side BC, two pairs of opposite side. Then pairs of opposite angles, angle A is opposite to angle C and angle B is opposite to angle D. So this were the pairs of adjacent side, adjacent angles and opposite sides and opposite angles of the quadrilateral ABCD. Now we'll learn different types of quadrilaterals. The first type of quadrilateral which we are going to study is a rectangle. Now what is rectangle? If all angles of quadrilateral are right angle, then the quadrilateral is said to be a rectangle. So here quadrilateral, in quadrilateral ABCD, all angles here, each angle of the rectangle quadrilateral is 90 degree, hence it is a quadrilateral ABCD is a rectangle. Here to find, if you want to find the area of a rectangle, the formula to find area of a rectangle is length into breadth. Now what, here quadrilateral rectangle. What are the properties of rectangle? So first property of rectangle is opposite sides of the rectangle are congruent. Opposite sides, here side AD is congruent to side BC and side AB is congruent to side CD. Opposite sides are congruent. Then diagonals of rectangle are congruent. So diagonal AC is congruent to diagonal BD of a rectangle, and diagonal bisect each other. Here diagonal bisect each other means here AM is congruent to MC and BM is congruent to MD. So these are the properties of rectangle. Second type of quadrilateral is a square. Now, if all sides and all angles of quadrilateral are congruent, then it is a quadrilateral is called as a square. Now here quadrilateral ABCD is a square where all sides are congruent and each angle, all angle is 90 degree. So hence quadrilateral ABCD is a square. Area of a square is equal to side square. Now properties of square. So first property is diagonals are of equal length. Diagonal AC is equal to diagonal BD. That is why they are congruent. Diagonal bisect each other. They bisect each other means AO is equal to OC and BO is equal to OD. And next is diagonals are perpendicular to each other. They bisect each other at right angle. The angle between two diagonals is 90 degree. Angle AOD is equal to 90 degree. And diagonal bisect opposite angles too. So these are the properties of the square. The next type of quadrilateral is a rhombus. If all sides of a quadrilateral are equal in length, that all sides of the quadrilateral are congruent, then the quadrilateral is called as rhombus. So area of a rhombus is equal to 1/2 into product of length of the diagonals D1 and D2. Properties of rhombus are opposite angles. Opposite angles of a rhombus are congruent. Here angle E is congruent to angle G and angle F is congruent to angle H. Then diagonals of rhombus bisect each other. They bisect each other. Here FO is equal to FOH and EO is equal to OG. Bisect each other. And this diagonals bisect each other at right angle. They are perpendicular to each other. EG is perpendicular to FH. So these are the properties of rhombus. Next type of quadrilateral is parallelogram. A quadrilateral having opposite sides parallel is called as parallelogram. Here in quadrilateral ABCD, AB is parallel to CD and BC is parallel to AD. Hence it is a parallelogram. Area of a parallelogram is equal to base into height. Formula to find the area of a parallelogram is base into height, base BC into height AE. Now properties of parallelogram are, first property, opposite angles of parallelogram, angle A is congruent to angle C. Opposite angles of parallelogram are congruent and angle B is congruent to angle D. Then opposite sides of the parallelogram are congruent. AB is congruent to CD and BC is congruent to AD. Then diagonal bisect each other. Diagonal AC and diagonal BD, they bisect each other, means AM is equal to MC and BM is equal to MD. And adjacent angles of parallelogram, angle A plus angle B is equal to 180. Adjacent angles are supplementary, and another pair is angle C plus angle D is equal to 180 degree. So adjacent angles of parallelogram are supplementary. The next type of quadrilateral, that is trapezium. So if only one pair of opposite sides of quadrilateral is parallel, then the quadrilateral is called as trapezium. Here in quadrilateral ABCD, here AB is parallel to DC. AB is parallel to DC, hence it is a trapezium. So to find area of a trapezium, we have the formula 1/2 into sum of length of parallel sides. Sum of length of parallel side means AB plus DC into height AP. Here height AP. So the trapezium, in a trapezium, out of four pairs of adjacent angles, two are supplementary. Out of four pairs, two pairs are supplementary. Here angle A plus angle D is equal to 180, and angle B plus angle C is equal to 180 degree. The next type of quadrilateral, that is kite. If one diagonal of a quadrilateral is perpendicular bisector of other diagonal, then the quadrilateral is called as kite. So here in quadrilateral ABCD, diagonal BD is perpendicular bisector of diagonal AC. Hence, it is a kite. In this figure, AB is congruent to BC and AC is congruent to AD. AD is congruent to CD and AM, the bisect AM is congruent to MC. So here area of a kite, formula to calculate area of kite is the product of the diagonal D1 into D2 divided by 2. Now properties of the kite. So two pairs of adjacent sides are congruent. Here two pairs of adjacent side AB is congruent to BC and AD is congruent to CD. And one pair of opposite angles is congruent. This one pair of opposite angle is congruent. Angle A is congruent to angle C. Hence, all of you note down all these definitions and properties of different types of quadrilateral in your notebook.